This letter is from my friend Phoebe. She's trying to build a machine learning model, but she only has access to a very small data set. So she sent me this letter with a question. Should she prioritize a low variance model or a high variance one? Let's dig into it. Back in school, the bias and variance trade-off was one of the first ideas I had to understand. I mean, that thing is everywhere, and there is so much confusion about it. To answer Phoebe's question, let's step away from all the complexity and start with the most basic ideas. Here it is. We have data, we have answers, and we use machine learning to learn the rules. But this is a hard process. We don't know what the real function that creates those answers is, so we can only create an estimate of it. Therefore, models will make mistakes. We call them prediction errors, and there are three components that contribute to it. One sec. Here is the formula. Every model contributes certain amount of bias and variance to the final prediction error. This term right here, irreducible error, is self-explanatory. We can't do anything about it. That's, for example, noise that exists in our data set. So we're gonna forget about it, and instead, we're gonna focus on the two components, bias and variance, that we can actually control. Here are the two principles I want you to remember. Bias is the assumptions your model makes about the function that it's trying to learn. For example, assuming that the data is linear when it's actually quadratic. If the model makes many assumptions, its bias will be really high. Variance, on the other hand, is about the sensitivity of your model to small variations in the training data set. Any model with too much freedom is likely to have high variance. Now, we still need to answer Phoebe's questions, but let's look at a couple of examples first. Here is the first example. I have a data set with this weird shape, and I'm trying to fit a linear model through it. And of course, I'm failing miserably. This model makes a huge assumption about the data. It assumes it's linear. In general, linear models are usually high bias because of this reason. Here I have a second model. Notice how this time the model touches every single sample. This model doesn't make any assumptions, but it's too sensible to every variation of the data. An example of a high variance model is a decision tree right before we start adding constraints to it. Okay, we know what bias is and we know what variance is, and by looking at this formula, if we want to reduce the error, we need less bias and less variance. But there is a tiny little problem. It's a trade-off. Bias and variance are these two sides connected in a really annoying way. If we try to decrease bias, variance will increase. And if we try to decrease variance, then bias will increase. The trick to every problem is trying to find a good balance between bias and variance. Something that looks like this. If we have a data set that looks like this, we want to find a model like this one here, model 2. We don't want too much bias, like in model 1, and we don't want too much variance, like in model 3. This, model 2, is the perfect model. Okay, now we have everything we need to answer Phoebe's question. Remember, Phoebe's working with a small data set and wants to know whether she should use a model with low or high variance. The size of her data set is the only information we have. Why do you think that's important? Let's take a look at two different extremes. If we have a data set with 1 million samples and we add a weird different data point to it, there's so much data that whatever is different about that data point will not be able to influence the model. But if we have a small data set like Phoebe does, any sample that's different will be very, very visible. A high variance model has too much sensitivity, and it will definitely pick up any small differences in the data and will likely overfit. Anytime you work with a small data set, variance is a concern. So dear Phoebe, you want to prioritize a low variance data set.